We'll start with a small quiz on C++ today. Three questions. Are you ready? Question number one. Do you put spaces around your binary operators? Question number two. How about where do the asterisks attach to the type name or to the variable name? Question number three. How about for loops? Do the opening brace stand on the same line as the for keyword or on a separate line? Let's take a fourth. Question number four. Tabs or spaces? And if spaces, how many spaces? Are you tired already? Yes, these discussions are tiresome. Let's have them once and for all. Welcome to Qt Widget and More. In this episode, we'll dive into the and more part, where we will introduce you to ClangFormat, a tool that will help you set your indentations and everything else for you so you don't have to worry about it. Welcome to the show. In this project, I've made a few changes. Let's see what these changes are. Git diff, and you can see exactly what we talked about. Should the ampersand be with the type or with the variable name? Should the for loop, should the opening brace with the for loop be on a separate line or on a line together with the for keyword? And finally, spaces, yes or no, between the binary operators. So I made this change. Let me commit it. Goes like this. First, git add minus p. I look through each of them, say, yep, that's exactly what I like. And yes, this is what I like too. And now I will run my commit, git commit minus m. And here we go. So what happened here was that when I ran git commit, git was running through its commit hooks, and it had one specifically which ran clang format. Running clang format on my code validates whether my code follows the guidelines that are set up in the clang format file. And as you could see in my commit, my changes did not follow those rules. So let's see what that configuration file looks like. It's a JSON file with some configuration in here. What the configuration exactly is, go and look that up in the documentation. And let's also see what the hook looked like. We had the hook right here. It's a very simple hook that simply run git clang format minus minus diff. Let's see what minus minus diff looks like here. Git clang format minus minus diff. And what you can see is exactly what git or what clang format would like to do to my code to follow its guidelines. So let's do what it asked us to. Let's run the git the clang format. I guess it was fast just right here. Git clang format. There we are. There we are. And what now happened is that it changed the files on my disk. Let's do a git add minus p once again to see those changes. First, it moves the ampersand for me. Okay, if you really insist, it moved the opening brace and added spaces around my minors. Well, if you insist, and now I'm ready to commit. So let me try my git commit again here. Minus bar, and this time it actually succeeded. Well, almost succeeded. I didn't have any changes on my disk because I moved to this weird change or this weird formatting just for this demonstration. But had there been changes, they would have been committed. It would be, to say the least, slightly annoying if every time you made some changes, you had to go to the shell, run git clang format. But fortunately, QCreator actually has a possibility to do that for you. Let's see how. So inside QCreator, all you need to do is go to Tools, Options, go to the Beautifier tab, choose Enable Auto Format on Autosave, choose Clang Format, go to Clang Format, and specify the binary location of your Clang Format. And then, of course, you also need to specify file, which is what will make it pick up the Clang underscore Clang Format file. Having done that, all you need to do is to go ahead and change your source code. So let's go with this weird definition here again. And now observe that when I press save, you can see my code up here, the asterisks there indicate that there's changes. Now I press save. Now Whoops, what happened there? Well, it ran ClangFormat on me and it moved this one up there. And you can see whatever weird thing I do to my format on save, it will fix it for me. And that's it for this time. We're one step closer to world peace. We no longer need to fight over spaces versus tabs, where the braces need to go, and so on and so on. And you're very welcome. I'm Jesper Pedersen from KDAB.